Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your home is going into foreclosure, and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases, even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. The 2019 KISW Rock Girl Search, it's on.
Yeah.
We're looking for you. Maybe you can help us look for someone as well, man. We're looking for a perfect rock girl, someone that wants to just hang out with us, help us with charity events, help us with rock events, just basically make us look better.
And create some great new friendships. That's been one of my fun things about seeing a lot of the current rock girls are posting, saying, hey, ladies, you should do this. And then they start sharing their own personal experiences of the friendships and the experiences that they're having. They have nothing to do with the radio station, but just have everything to do with the fact that they all hit it off and became great friends.
Would you like to be a friend?
Part of a sisterhood.
Yeah!
With some ugly brothers known as us, yeah, your coworkers.
Yeah, that's a good point. Well, if you'd like to be a rock girl or know someone who would love to be a rock girl, get in touch with us. Go to KISW.com. That's where you get all the info.
Let's play B-Migs.
It's time to play the game.
Yeah!
So everybody scream his name. B-Migs, don't be a loser.
Whoa!
B-Migs, you're a loser.
Pump it up for Monday.
Up. Oh, yeah.
Pump it up.
Thanks for the addition there, BJ.
No problem, buddy. I'm glad I could help.
Looks like you're pumped up today.
Doing pretty well.
Nice.
Yeah, doing pretty well. I thought I'd be a lot tired, more tired than I am, but I'm doing okay.
I know. Steve was busy all weekend. You were busy all weekend.
Yeah. Vicky's always a busy beaver.
Yeah, she
excuse
is.
Excuse me?
Well, that's just for another time, another story.
He's not wrong.
Moving on from that, let's get to our contestant. We got John and Buckley to take on Steve. John, are you there, sir?
Actually, John is not there. He left.
Oh, no. Poor John's gone.
So we're going to Mike in Oak Harbor instead.
Mike. Mike, are you there?
I sure am.
Sweet. What's he playing for today, Steve?
Rev, he's playing for some tickets. Actually, you take you and three of your friends to Monster Jam at CenturyLink Field on March 16th. Go to KISW.com for all the details on Monster Jam. And if you want tickets, they're available now at Ticketmaster.com.
All right, Steve, get out of here.
Talk about Monster Jam?
For those playing at home, Mike will have 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. Mike, you can pass all you want, but you will only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Let's do it.
What space lies between Baltic Avenue and Reading Railroad on a standard Monopoly game board?
What?
Would you like to pass?
Yeah.
In the MCU, which character's alter ego is Iron Man?
Tony Stark.
Yes. What fruit juice is added to a cosmopolitan martini to make it pink?
Grapefruit?
No.
Nope. Cranberry?
Yes. What decade saw the opening of the first Starbucks store?
70s.
Yes. Who played Doc Brown in Back to the Future?
Christopher Lloyd.
Yes.
Marty.
What is the largest living bird on Earth?
Ostrich?
Yes. Before being renamed, what was Mumbai called?
Cool play. Math.
In what year of the mid-70s did Wheel of Fortune debut?
Say it again?
In what year of the mid-70s did Wheel of Fortune debut?
79.
No.
78.
No. What was the last one?
77?
No. One, two, three, four, five, correct.
I'd say mid-70s, Mike.
I did, and unfortunately, maybe you missed that.
77, 78, 79, not in the mid-70s.
Nope, and maybe his phone was breaking up there. Mike caused that little loss there.
I feel bad about everybody.
You feel bad about everybody.
Nobody cares about this. I'm unimpressed.
Oh, yeah. All of those. It just fit all of those show memes in there all together into one thing.
See that? You don't even have to listen to the show anymore. We just summed up everything.
Unimpressive radio. That's not what he cares about. BJ and Migs.
Mm-hmm. Who cares?
Pew, nobody.
Pew, pew. Steve, are you ready?
Yes! Yes! Yes!
What space lies between Baltic Avenue and Reading Railroad on a standard Monopoly game board?
Atlantic.
No.
Park.
No.
Chance.
No. In the MCU, which character's alter ego is Iron Man?
Tony Stark.
Yes. What fruit juice is added to a cosmopolitan martini to make it pink?
Apple.
No.
Apple. Pink lemonade.
No.
Fruit juice?
Pink lemonade.
Yes.
Tomato.
No.
What
decade saw the opening of the first Starbucks store?
What decade?
Yeah.
70s.
Yes. Who played Doc Brown in Back to the Future?
Oh, Marty.
Yeah.
Christopher Lloyd.
Yes. Noice. What is the largest living bird on Earth?
An eagle.
No.
Pterodactyl.
No.
Parrot.
No.
Parrot, yes.
Before being renamed, what was Mumbai called?
Moom, see you later.
No.
That's it.
Moom high?
No.
Moom high.
Dubai?
No.
Dubai.
In what year of the mid-70s did Wheel of Fortune debut?
What?
In what year of the mid-70s?
76.
No.
75. 74.
75, yes. Too late. And also, you lose. 5-3.
You know what? Mike hung up thinking he wasn't going to do well, but...
Call him back. He's
all right. I'll call Mike back. He actually did manage to beat Steve.
Which means...
Yeah, your performance there was unimpressive, unfortunately.
It was, actually.
Some of the ones that you did not get correct that Mike did get correct. He knew that it was cranberry juice in a cosmopolitan to make it pink.
Oh.
Not tomato. Oh, my
Dang.
God.
Oh.
What? That tomato juice in a Cosmo?
Do you have a Bloody Mary?
Yeah, but it's...
Tomato juice with vodka?
Yeah, but there's other things in a Cosmo, right?
I mean, don't know.
Well, it's not poo-pooing the fact that you would put tomato juice with alcohol. It's just that there's no tomato juice in Cosmos.
I understand that, but it's not as disgusting
He's really upset at your Sex and the City ignorance is what he's upset.
I've never seen an episode.
Yeah. I think I might have seen one on accident. the largest living bird on Earth is an ostrich.
We've asked that question a lot, and Steve does never get it.
I know. This is great.
Yeah, keep asking. He'll get it one day.
I don't even remember what the question was.
There you go. The space between Baltic Avenue and Reading Railroad on a standard Monopoly game board?
Is it Mediterranean?
No.
Oh, damn
it. It's not a property, but it is income tax.
Income tax.
And a lot of people are chiming in, the Beat Makes Police. It's Reading, not Reading.
No, it's not. Reading. It is Reading.
It's not Reading. Reading,
you know what happened last time that I asked this question?
We had the same conversation.
No, but it was the opposite because I said Reading Railroad, and then everyone says, no, it's Reading, like Reading, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, exactly. That's so, a lot of West Coasters don't know that there is a Reading, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, it's going to be one half is going to say that I'm wrong, and then the next time I change it, the other half is going to say I'm wrong.
They wrong, Reb. You right this time.
Yeah, this time. Before being renamed, what was Mumbai called?
Mumbai was Bombay.
Yes.
The English went over there and said, guess what, India, we don't like this name, and like we do, we're going to take it over, and like us, India has an Independence Day from England, just like we do.
Mm-hmm.
And they have a big party, and I like to go sometimes.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, Indian food, plus they're celebrating the same thing I celebrate, F you, England. Yeah, it's pretty good. It's pretty cool.
Congratulations to Mike on beating Steve this morning.
That's right, man. You can even tie Steve and get a prize. That's a nice thing. All part of Beat Migs. All part of what makes life great.
Yes.
All right. I got a new survey asking people how much they think they're spending every month on subscriptions, including cell phone service.
Oh, geez.
Yeah.
Cell phone service? I don't want to go down that road.
No, you don't.
It's just too much.
Well, that's why I'm surprised at this number. People said, I'm only spending $80 a month.
Bull crap.
On my subscriptions and my cell phone service. That was the answer given in the survey.
Is that including, I would imagine that includes like the Netflixes, the Spotifys, the Hulus.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, man. I'm not even. I wish I was paying that little for my cell phone bill.
Yeah.
That little. That's sad to even say that. Yeah.
But how about they have underestimated it by three times, basically, because it's three times more expensive than that. People dropping about $240 a month on all of it.
See, if you include me covering my wife's cell phone, because I'm paying for both of ours, then with all the services, it's around that.
I'm still paying for my kid's cell phone. Because they're all on my plan, so it's just like, it's just difficult.
Can I get on your plan?
Yeah, me too.
Too late, buddy.
How many people?
Come on.
How many people are we on your plan?
You're not in my family. Too late.
Yeah, I mean, I see you more than your son.
Really?
Yeah, he doesn't ever look at you.
Well, that's true.
I'm in the room more with you than him. True.
That is a good point. You are.
See, I'm still on my mom's cell phone plan.
Can I get on her plan?
I send her money every month. So I have to send her money.
Oh, is that what you do?
Can you send money in for me, too?
Would you show Joey how that works, how you can send money to your parents to pay for the stuff that they got? Show him how that works.
You think we're going to be able to change him now?
Well, you know, it's always worth a try. Anything to give me a couple extra
bucks.
You can
show him. He's not going to do it.
That's I know.
Yeah. So what is it? Yeah, you're right, Steve. Cell phone service, cable, Wi-Fi, Netflix, Hulu, Amazon Prime. Also, cloud storage. Don't forget that, because we pay for, I mean, I pay for iCloud, Dropbox. I do.
What are you dropping?
What am I?
Like,
what am I
99 cents a month?
What am I dropping in the
That's
box?
That's what I'm doing. Yeah, for the iCloud. Yeah.
That's I think I'm doing more.
Oh.
I store everything in there.
How much do you have in there, man? I could hold a lot for 99 cents a month.
Yeah. Well, maybe that's what I'm paying. I overestimate what I'm paying. Maybe you're right. Maybe that's all I'm paying. I feel like I got just the lowest plan possible.
Then that's what you're probably paying. Yeah.
I'll consider dropping the 99 cents a month just so I don't get the stupid notification every month saying, hey, you're out of storage.
Well, yeah, that's why I probably was like, it was all on laziness.
Yeah.
It's like, do I want to sit through all of my crap and delete all these pictures, or do I just want to add my, pay 99 cents more so I don't have to delete 1,500 pictures of Lulu?
They're smart. They know us.
Yeah.
They really, really do. Yeah, because since we don't have to go and develop film anymore, because that was the beautiful thing about taking pictures. You knew you didn't have that much film available, so you really had to be smart about the shots you took.
You had to make it count.
Yeah, now it's just like everyone's got their phone up, and you know, whether it's my wife who doesn't realize if you keep your finger on there, you're taking 500 of the same pictures, which, you know, it's just can't seem to grasp that particular technology.
Although I'm noticing some photographers are now kind of going back to the old ways with using, like my buddy Wes Smith, who's a really good, he's a very good photographer. He does awesome pictures for wrestling, like 3-2-1 Battle and Defy, and now he makes it a point to always carry a disposable camera with him. So he'll take pictures with the fancy digital camera, but then he'll also grab his disposable, and I've now seen other people do it as well, and they'll take pictures, and man, there's something about it. Like, I remember thinking that these pictures weren't anything special when you had a disposable camera, but they just look so much cooler. There's like a certain warmth to them, and just there's something so candid about the disposable picture, because you're just married to that shot.
Yeah.
You can't just go through your digital stuff and delete all, you know what I mean? You just, this is one of the pictures you got to work with.
And I had a photographer once, a friend of mine, take a picture with like an instant camera.
Mm-hmm.
One of the, it wasn't quite, what are they called?
Polaroid.
It wasn't that
That's
brand.
That's pretty popular again too now.
Like you're right. It does have this warmth to it. And he used like a black and white film. And it was just a really nice picture. Yeah. Didn't have to do any filters, any editing.
It's a nice keepsake too. I don't know, if you're like a celeb or something like that and people want to take pictures with you, it's kind of nice if you do that thing. And then it doesn't go on the internet. I suppose you could take a picture of the picture and put it on the internet. Could do that. But then you can autograph it if you know, if somebody was looking to do that.
Oh, the old Polaroid deal.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I mean, there is something to be said about that, the old throwback, the retro.
I got those apps, too. You take a picture and instantly print the picture that way, too.
Oh, do you have a little printer on you?
Yeah, you have to have like a little, it's like, it's probably more money than you really want to spend for a stupid picture.
Yeah, I think the disposables are nicer.
Yeah.
Yeah. It is time for Listeners on the Loose. This is where you pick the topic. You guide the show. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. Your calls, your texts at 917 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs. Mornings on The Rock. 99.9 KISW.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. It's Listeners on the Loose. Brought to you by Beacon Plumbing, Heating, and Mechanical. Hey, Steve!
Yes, sir.
Stop freaking! Call Beacon.
Stop freaking. Call Beacon.
Listeners on the Loose, where you pick the topic, you guide the show. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. Whatever it is you want to talk about. You want to talk about the Oscars, even though no one cares? No one cares, but I mean, officially they can, because it's Listeners on the Loose, right?
Yes.
You can talk about wrestling, talk about Danny, whatever you want to talk about.
Vicky.
Yeah.
But make sure you follow this rule.
That's to show some energy and bring it. Otherwise, you'll be gone. and we'll have to say goodbye to you.
Goodbye, old friend.
206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999.
Somebody just says, where is it? Do the people in the room, Steve, realize that they're sitting next to a world champion wrestler? If not, inform these mofos.
Huh?
I did not realize I was standing next to a world champion wrestler. You Danny, are. When did you start wrestling? I don't.
You know, about a week ago.
He's looking good in there, man. He's been busting his ass. Yeah. He's now in the WWE.
I know Vicky was into being tossed, you know, like the old sport of dwarf tossing. So I don't know if it's, are you a champion?
I think that's illegal now here in Washington.
Yeah, it is illegal in Washington.
Vicky tossing is still legal, okay? That you can still do.
No, in Lake Stevens it is, but not in Seattle.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
All right,
last
so.
Last night I made history like I promised on Friday.
You made history, did you?
And I'm the very first ever in the world of professional wrestling verified champion.
What does that even mean, verified champion?
You know, in wrestling, I'm the local celebrity Steve Miggs. People don't like me. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, well, you know what? We're all on the same page.
And it's inspired by all the douchey people in radio that I've encountered in my life that like to brag about thinking that they're a celebrity when they're not.
Okay.
Thinking that being verified on Twitter is awesome. So I channeled that. And last night, I pulled out a championship belt that I might have used as a weapon, but whatever.
Okay.
And it's a giant Twitter check mark.
Wait, you made your Twitter own belt? Birds. So you really weren't given a belt? You pretty much just got your own belt, is what you're
saying.
Well,
they weren't going to give me the respect of letting me compete for a title, so I figured I'd just make my own title, and there it is.
Oh, my God. It is a championship belt with the big blue
with rhinestones.
What? Oh.
And
that thing is
quote-unquote
ridiculous.
Diamonds.
It's got the birds from Twitter.
It's got the birds.
It's the verified check mark, really? Yep.
Yes.
You wore that?
Yes.
And now you're crowning yourself a champion.
I'm the verified champ.
So that's a new division that you made up. You're the verified
Absolutely.
Champ.
You need to be verified if you want to win it.
Wow. Oh, nice.
Wow. And it went over great, DJ. Kids loved it. I did not realize. I have so many pictures since all these little kids wanting to take pictures rocking the belt. Oh. It was a great time. Shout out to Without a Cause Wrestling, which is the promotion that I'm a part of in Everett. Another show is going to be happening next month at the end of the month, I believe on the 24th. But last night was a real fun one. And I did not realize how popular it would be with the kids. Even the kids that were booing me during the match all came up during intermission wanting to take a picture with the belt, which was pretty sweet.
I am noticing the kid with the belt, though, does have a Migs Stinks t-shirt on.
Yeah. And so did this little girl, too, Jameson. She was rocking a Migs Stinks shirt while she had a WWE championship belt and now a Twitter verified championship belt in her hands.
Okay.
The highlight.
That belt is ridiculously, like, over the top.
It's so ridiculous. It's so awesome. So the highlight, though, was I came out and I, you know, obviously the Saturday night I got to be a part of the Ronald McDonald House charity event with the Seattle Thunderbirds, which was so damn amazing and special to be able to help out every year and raising money for a great cause. So I come out and I'm typical bad guy persona. I'm like, what a difference a day makes. Yesterday I'm playing hockey in front of several, you know, thousands of people.
You're a good guy.
Doing great stuff, and today I'm here in Everett.
Getting cussed out by children.
And I'm like, what a difference a day makes when yesterday I'm helping raise money for the Ronald McDonald House for great families, great kids that have been battling some awful things, and the room starts clapping, right? So then I go, unlike tonight, where I'm around a bunch of piss poor parents and bratty kids, and everyone's like,
Of course.
I say this because then during intermission, you know, hanging out, taking pictures with the belt and all that, these two cute little kids come up and they're adorable. They're probably like 10, 11, right? And they're like, okay, here we go again. We're going to take a picture with the belt. And they come up and they're like, we are two beautiful little girls that don't have cancer. And then they step on my foot and ran away.
What?
And everyone around me, I swear, there was a group of people. They all looked at me. I looked at them like, did that just happen?
That just happened.
Because that was quite possibly the most amazing thing I've ever experienced. I've never had kids be that mad at me.
Wow. And did you say anything about cancer at all?
Well, I did. Like I said, I had that whole promo about how I was doing good stuff for kids battling cancer with the Ronald McDonald House.
I didn't realize they extrapolated that. And
yes.
Oh, yeah.
And then I stepped on my foot and ran away.
Oh, so they were like, just because we don't have cancer doesn't mean we're not good kids.
Right.
Oh, they did. Oh, that's so awesome. You know what? Sometimes you get in a little kid's brain to figure out what ticks them off. They're like, you know what? We're good kids just because we don't have cancer.
Right.
Oh, wow.
I was like, MMOM, like, that's better than the time that kid said that they effing hated me.
Yeah. And they stepped on your toe, which I forgot.
And not like joking stepped on. They just stomped on my foot and ran off.
I forgot that kid's maneuver.
Yeah.
Wow.
It was fun.
Dang, where were the parents when all this was going on?
They were hanging out, doing other stuff, I bet. Look, maybe in a bar. I mean, you know, there's an opportunity.
I get a beer? Let your kid yell at me.
See, you're a better man than me. If a kid is going to step on my foot, that's when I might lose it.
What am I going to do, BJ?
Oh, I don't know.
Start chasing him with the belt?
I would have got
to get on to your verified champ.
Pick up a chair. All right, you want to wrestle, kid?
So Steve pulled a $1 million man. Hilarious. Oh, 100% yeah. Inspired by the $1 million man, Ted DiBiase.
That is so great.
In World of Wrestling back in the 80s, he showed up one time because he was like, you know, I need a more glorious and more impressive belt than the championship. And he had this giant diamond belt.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
It's amazing because those belts look amazing now. So he started that whole thing, when you think about it, making these really gaudy, ridiculous belts.
His was gaudy to the next level.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So it was a great time. Again, I hope anyone who went, a lot of people came out that never been to a wrestling event and had a really fun time. It was great action, great wrestlers, and just fun.
And
it's a fun vibe at the Normana Lodge, which is awesome people there. Shout out to them. They're always great, and it's just something fun to do on a Sunday afternoon in Everett.
And now you have a verified championship.
Yes.
That you're assaulting people
now with. You're around. Maybe tomorrow, if you guys are lucky, I'll bring the belt in.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh,
so you guys can take pictures with it.
If we're around tomorrow. Yeah. We got other stuff to do, Steve. We're not coming lucky. Around.
Boy, I can't
wait
for
that. There's one guy I'm going around.
What a treat.
I'm telling people, take out your cameras, tweet a picture of me with the belt, and if you're lucky, I'll retweet it. And I look at this one guy, I'm like, he's booing me. I'm like, not you, though, because I'm sure you've never gotten lucky in your life.
Oh, nice.
Like, yeah.
Okay.
It's fun being a jerk, BJ.
Oh.
Now I understand why you're such a miserable person.
See, you got to make a whole, career out of it, buddy. See?
Oh, so it says, my worst nightmare came to life in the latest episode of The Orville. Have you been watching it?
I didn't watch the latest ep. I haven't watched it yet.
Can I kind of spoiler alert it?
Yeah, well, what do you think, Vicky? Because Vicky and I watch it.
I haven't seen it either, but go for it.
All right, it says AI decides to kill everyone. Crazy episode.
Oh.
I did see the teaser for like next week, so that makes sense.
Oh, is that Isaac?
Mm-hmm.
Is he the AI they're talking about, Isaac? The one that went nutty?
See?
Oh, okay. Oh, I heard it was a great episode.
Foreshadowing.
My buddy told me last night it was a good, the other night it was a good episode, and but they were nice enough not to spoil it. But that's okay. I don't mind to know a little bit about it. And therefore, this is interesting.
Ooh.
Yeah. Okay. People are digging that show. I think because they don't like Star Trek Discovery, which is why a lot of people are loving Voyager, just because it's more Star Trek than they remember from Star Trek Discovery.
I enjoyed the first couple episodes. I think it kind of fell off the radar for my wife. So since the wife's not into it, I kind of gave up on it.
My wife says the same thing. But again, it's so much like Star Trek The Next Generation with a little bit more humor that eventually you go, oh, I don't think I like Star Trek The Next Generation, so why would I really like this show? Just because it's got a couple more jokes. But us old Star Trek Next Gen fans, my gosh, it's such an homage, to the point that, you know, you wonder why Paramount doesn't go, hey, you know, Seth, pretty much you've just created our show here. But it's a good show. It's on Fox. If you liked Star Trek back in the day.
Or if you like Seth MacFarlane type humor.
Yeah, you get both. You get the mixture of both in that one. Yeah. So listeners on the loose, you pick the topic, you guide the show. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999.
So I want to know our advice on this. This is a good one. Guys, do you think this is odd? I was at the doctor's for my yearly checkup, and some guy in the waiting room came over, sat next to me, and said he would regret not talking to me and asked me out for dinner. I don't know. Hitting on someone at the doctor's office seems a little off limits, if you ask me. What do you guys think?
Here's what I think. I think it's the way you approach anybody. I think that, you know, she's trying to come up with like a rule, but the bottom line is she just didn't dig the guy. Because if he was a charming, amazing guy, it wouldn't matter where you get hit on, especially if he knew how to do it the right way.
And love happens in the craziest places.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, they make you stand kind of far behind the next person when you're at the counter. It's a very private thing.
But what about the waiting room area? That's what I'm picturing.
That's kind of a pretty private thing, I think.
I don't know. Everyone's sitting next to each other. When I go get my physical check, no, man, everyone around me, they're really old looking and weird.
See, it's a vulnerable place, depending upon what was she was in for. Right.
Yearly checkup.
Yeah. Oh, she said yearly checkup. Okay. Yeah.
Yearly checkup or the other checkup?
Oh, good call.
When I save a few dollars, I'll do your checkup for you in my van outside. Is that not a good way to hit on someone?
No. Not at the doctor's office. Maybe a bowling alley.
Fair enough.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a, you know, for a man, And I mean, I don't know, for whoever's the aggressor in any kind of relationship, I don't know in gay relationships who's actually the one that picks up who. I have no idea. But in the male-female relationship, stereotypically, it's the man that approaches the woman. And it's always tough for a man to know, is this the right time with a stranger? How do I approach a stranger and find her and tell her I find her intriguing?
Like, you hear about it happening at like grocery stores all the time. And I'm like, I can never imagine back in my single days going up to somebody and be like, hey, I see the way you're handling those melons.
Yeah.
My name's Steve.
See, that's
I'd rather that to the doctor's office.
Yeah?
Yeah. The doctor's office just seems kind of weird.
You don't know what they're going in for either.
Right. Yeah. They could be going in for like a herp checkup or something.
That, or like, what if, you know, they actually have something wrong with them and that's, they're in that mindset. You know, I'm going in, I'm upset. And now you're trying to hit on me. This isn't making me feel better.
But what I would tell any woman is, if you're looking for someone in your life, why would you eliminate anything if the guy was cool? If he's not cool, sure, you're going to say no.
That doesn't make you cool, hitting on somebody in the doctor's office. But that immediately eliminates
it. So if Jason Momoa is in the doctor's office and you're
that
single.
That doesn't count. That's like an extreme celebrity money.
Well, I mean, somebody that you could actually spend your life with, like, oh my God, this could be the right one.
Jason's the right guy for her.
That's a good point. Probably isn't. Yeah.
Yeah, he works out a lot. I feel like I couldn't keep up.
Yeah, you could.
Like Jack Black.
So you're saying, Vicky, no way. It doesn't matter if he's Mr. Right. Don't approach me in the doctor's
office. Not at the doctor's office.
So what do you do? Wait till they leave the doctor's office? What if you
both leave at the same time, maybe, but like, sense the tone. Like, you're never, if someone's in a good mood, they're like, okay, whatever, chatting up the person at the desk, then okay, maybe when they leave. But at the doctor's office, I feel like that's a violation.
See, us guys, we're like, whenever the opportunity presents itself, we always keep our eyes open because you never know when where all of a sudden the one can be there.
Yeah, I've never been that person I could even consider. I would just psych myself out every time, no matter where. I mean, bars, you feel a little bit more comfortable because that's like a social mingling kind of a place, but at a grocery store, where you're like, at church. I'm like, no.
Oh, not even at church.
Because I couldn't imagine.
I feel like you know that everybody's into what you're into, and that's a big one when it comes to religion.
But then think about it, if it doesn't go well, that's the place you go every week.
Oh, I hadn't thought about that.
You know, at least with the grocery store, you could kind of maybe switch over to Fred Meyer.
Could you pray to God, though? Could you please hit her with lightning?
That's a little excessive.
Well, I mean, you know, I mean, that way you could
maybe sit in a different row.
Yeah, all right, fine, you know. I suppose I was like, God, look, it didn't work out. She's probably not one of us. Take care of her. No. Yeah.
Wow.
That's how I'd be. That's probably why I don't get invited to a lot of churches. It's Listeners on the Loose. You pick the topic. You got the show.
I'm going to take a couple steps over to the left in case that lightning hits you.
206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. Your calls, your texts, 933 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. It's Listeners on the Loose. You pick the topic. You guide the show. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999.
We got a text message. Someone says, hey, could you guys give a quick plug for a friend of mine? My buddy Rain Raven is going to be on The Voice. He passed the prelimit earlier rounds.
Yes. Easy for you to say. You can do it, Steve.
Preliminary.
Yeah!
Hey. Woo! He passed a preliminary round and made it to the blind auditions. He's a Tacoma local, so support local and support Rain. Rain Raven, everybody.
Very nice.
That's exciting. How about you? I'm about to start watching The Voice again.
Yeah, you watched it for a while and stopped. I don't even know who's on it anymore.
I don't either. I would imagine Adam Levine is still there.
I know. I think I saw a commercial. It was like Kelly Clarkson! The one married to Chrissy Teigen. John Legend. Yeah.
Is Blake and Adam?
Blake is still, I'm not sure about Adam.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Well, still, that's exciting, man. Yeah. Local person getting that opportunity.
Yeah, although we've had a few folks that are local people that have gone to those kind of shows and done well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, good for them.
I got a text message to go back to the whole topic of someone hitting on somebody at the doctor's office.
Yes.
Someone says, I more or less agree with BJ on this.
Whoa, is this a guy or girl?
I don't know. It's a guy, Andrew right. Needham Claw. I understand it's not the best place to try and meet someone at a doctor's office, but if you get a vibe about someone and you want to meet them, you're probably never going to see them again in your life, so why not do it at that point? You either take the chance or you never know.
Aww.
P.S. I've never hit on someone at the doctor's office. LOL.
How about this, Vicky? Because Vicky, of course, you know, she doesn't, you know, Vicky doesn't believe you should hit another doctor's office. What if they just give you a card or write or our Facebook contact and say, look, I know this is not the right place.
What, a Facebook stalker?
Well, no. In other words, they, I always thought I would give somebody my contact info, go, look, I know this is weird. I know it's a doctor's office, but I don't know. There's something about you, man. You seem like a really cool person. And if you ever would like to go for coffee, here's a card. I don't want to bother you, but you just seem awesome. And then be done. I mean, just be complimentary, be awesome, but show that you understand. And nothing.
I mean, I'm feeling that a lot of the times when guys are hitting on girls at the doctor's office, they're just sitting there by themselves. If they're interacting with other people, whether at the front desk or, you know, with you, and they're friendly and they're actually talking to you, then sure, go for it. But if they're just sitting there by themselves and you're like, this person's hot, like, it seems a little weird to just bother them.
Nice.
And like, hey, here's, you know, I want to go out with you at the doctor's office.
I'll be happy being lonely for the rest of your life.
Yeah. Lonely, okay, girl.
I'd rather be lonely than stuck with an old creep like you. So,
well, I don't know that that's the only option.
It could be a young creep bothering you too. What about that guy? Do people ever really meet at grocery stores? Because, Steve, you talked about it. Like, you go, I don't know.
Yeah, you'll find someone at the grocery store.
It's actually not a dumb cliche. Actually, they did do a study about this. It really does happen, and a lot more than we think. 1 in 3 people say they know at least one person who's gone on a date with someone they did actually meet at a grocery store. And almost half of us have actually flirted with someone while buying groceries. I never think of that because I'm always on a mission at a grocery store. Like, I don't want to be bothered.
Yeah. Don't bother me, man. I'm trying to just find the stuff that's on my damn grocery list.
Don't bother you guys BJ, don't bother you while you're at the grocery store, but okay at the doctor's office.
Yeah, you know, it's an interesting thing.
Yeah. It's harder to find that jar of pickles than chlamydia cream, Vicky.
At a doctor's office, you're waiting. You have nothing to do but wait. So I got to sit there and do nothing. I'm feeling vulnerable because I'm going to get a checkup.
Well, you don't read Highlights, the magazine?
Yeah.
That Goofus and Gallant?
Hell yeah. They are hilarious.
Goofus and Gallant. Oh, my God.
Hardy hard.
It's been a long time since I've read those magazines. Used to read them a lot because we took the kids.
I also like reading that six-year-old edition of People magazine that they always have on the table.
That's the best, isn't it? Oh, wow. So this is what I should have done 6 years ago. Yeah. How about, as far as the meeting in the frozen food aisle, they're saying that could be cliche. The survey says the 3 spots where you most likely meet someone are the beer, wine, and liquor aisle. Well, that makes sense.
You like the party.
And Steve, apparently the produce section. So that handling your melons line, it's a good one.
Have you found the eggplant yet, man?
Yeah. It's a nice eggplant.
And the checkout line. I have done stuff in the checkout line where I think maybe, you know what, if I was single, I could have got a date.
Oh, yeah?
Well, I've had, like, some ladies that have been fumbling for cash or just been really harried, and I'm just like, you know what, just charge that to mine. I'll be like, just put that on mine, and you go ahead. Or I let somebody go ahead of me because I've got the one item.
I'll be your sugar daddy.
See, that's a smooth move.
Yeah.
I like that.
Oh, I see. So,
like, especially if it's, like, one thing, or watch, it's, like, cupcakes and tampons. You'll look like a hero.
Yeah. See, that's the thing. So I was like, go ahead of me, or I'll take care of that. That's fine. You know, and I've often thought when they left, they were like, they really gave me a nice look. And I thought, ooh, if I wasn't married, I wonder if this would be my shot.
Like, let's go.
Yeah. But then I feel like I'm bothering them. If they're on their way out the door, what am I going to do? Go, hey, hi, by the way. See, my brain tells me that's bothering them. Whereas if they're just sitting at the doctor's office, where are they going?
Hey, someone says my wife was the cashier at Albertsons in Fairwood, and that's how I met her. Another person I met, my wife at Walmart. Been together 13 years.
Aww.
The person says, I bet Vicky's had sex in the doctor's waiting room office. Oh, well.
It's not a romantic place, is it?
No, also, since I worked at a tattoo shop, I have now have this idea that any floor at a tattoo shop or any medical type building where there's fluid is automatically just covered in hepatitis.
Oh, how
so
about that?
So I would never do anything in a bathroom at a nurse's or doctor's office kind of thing.
So guys, if you're looking for a crazy person, Vicky is your girl.
I think they knew that already. You don't need to whisper it to them.
So you're ready? You're ready for the pickup lines that'll work at a grocery store?
Yes.
I got the two best ones. All right, if you're a dude, here's the one you use. You go up to the chick and go, hey, I can't find something. Do you know where it is?
Oh. Wait, if the woman says that to you?
No, you say that to the girl.
Oh, okay.
You go up to her and go, miss, yes, I don't know where the hell the melons are. And if you have nice melons.
And then she walks you to it, and you're like, hey, you just walk ahead of me. I'll watch you from that.
Yeah, that's it.
I'd be a little worried that I'd look like I'm dressed as an employee and that's all I'd be thinking about.
Well, if you're wearing a red shirt at Target, expect to be asked a question.
Right.
That's what's so frustrating about Target. It's like, don't ever wear red in Target. Exactly. People will bother you all khakis. Day.
Or a blue it's shirt at Best
so
Buy.
So many times,
yeah. Yes.
Yeah, it's happened so many times where it's like, God, I want to go out to Target and go, will you please wear uniforms again? This is ridiculous. Everybody thinks I'm a creep, and it's like they're wearing some form of red. How about this one for girls? You ask the guy, can you help me reach something? That's Vicky's life.
I mean, yeah. I'm just a climber. I'll climb it all and grab what I
need.
I've
had women say that to me before.
Oh, they were hitting
like,
me.
Like, I need help breathing. Like, you're tall. I'm like, no, I'm not.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. You say the funniest things.
Yeah.
You know what you should definitely do next time you see a girl reaching for something? Go right up next to her and reach for it and then put it in your basket and walk away.
Oh, sucker.
I can reach.
I'm married. And just walk away.
Yeah. You can look but can't touch.
Yeah.
Don't this. It's like sachet, boy.
Yeah. Vicky just has advice that will have us pretty much get rejected by women.
I mean, yeah. You don't.
I got rejected by one. That's all. Accepted by one. That's all I need.
Okay.
I got rejected by many.
That was a Freudian slip.
Rejected by many, accepted by one.
That's it.
Marriage.
That's what marriage. You meant
to say. Good job.
Okay.
So it says, I'm a woman. I don't agree with Vicky. I say, go for it. You miss 100% of the chances that you don't take. Very Wayne Gretzky of you.
Yeah. Here's what I think, and I think Vicky's in this category. I think women are very fickle. It depends on how they're approached. It depends on the vibe of the guy. I don't care where it is. I think you could be anywhere, and a woman, if you have the right approach and she's digging you just as a human, I think that's the time. I really, really do. I don't care where it is, because I've seen so many guys strike out where I'm like, oh, dude, you just, yeah, that was the whole wrong approach.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like, I know what I'm talking about, but still. That's my belief. I could be wrong.
I don't know. Doctor's office or therapist office, anything like that.
Therapist office, I go, look, we're both crazy, so who else is going to be with us? That would be my line.
So he says, I met my wife at Fred Meyer. I hate that bitch.
Whoa. Jeez.
Tell us how you really feel.
Didn't expect that one.
Whoa. Another text says, my husband was my patient at the hospital.
Oh.
That's going to break some rules.
See, at that point, I mean, I've often wondered about that. Like, how could you strike up that conversation? Where, you know, like, if you really, really like somebody, like
maybe
a massage therapist.
Just a casual conversation, you realize you're having fun talking to the person.
Yeah.
And then that person had enough gumption to ask you out.
That's amazing that you would do that with your doctor. That takes a lot of, because, you know, to me, I have a female doctor. If I was single, I don't know if I'd have the balls, and she would know exactly if I do or not. Wow. Let's go to O-Face. Hey, O-Face in Roosevelt.
Is that
right
his
there.
Birth given name?
That's his birth given name. What's up, O-Face?
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, sir. What you got?
No, I think I got a story to take the cake on meeting your significant other. How about I-5 rush hour traffic at the U District?
How'd you do that?
Random day.
You just roll on your
Seriously.
Window?
Well, she had the exact same kind of car I do, and they're kind of rarish cars, which told me she was into racing and into sport driving and all that stuff.
Uh-huh.
And I just ended up rolling down my window and started chatting her up, and next thing I know, we're going on hikes, and come April, it's going to be a year.
But did you guys have to, like, yell your phone number to her, or her yell?
We just kept traffic at a pace behind us. We were, you know, creeping along in traffic and just chatting back and forth, and I tried to get her to join the Facebook group that we were part of, and she sped off screaming, I'm not an adult, and you know, it's pretty good. It's pretty good.
Well, but how did you end up getting her digits enough to connect?
So what I did was posted a photo in that car group I was trying to get her to be a part of on Facebook, and somebody recognized her car and got a hold of her, and just randomly she ended up started stalking me, made sure I wasn't a serial killer or anything, and then asked me if I wanted to go on a hike.
Wow, I'd be afraid that I'd look like a stalker if I did that.
Yeah, me too. Yeah. I, you know, that's
it was one of those days. It was one of those days.
Wow, good for you.
Good luck to you, Fred Durst.
Vicky, how would you... would you be a little weirded out if the guy, you drove away, you were chatting with the guy, you obviously wanted nothing to do with him because you gave him no point of contact, and then he posts a picture of your car in a Facebook group? How would you feel about that?
That's kind of creepy and stalkerish.
Oh, that's what I thought.
But she seemed to be okay with it. That goes back to that texture. You got to take a chance. You miss all the shots if you don't take
it's
them.
It's so true. You really just got to take shots. What else are you going to do? Take a chance. If Vicky tells you to go, then you go, all right, whatever. That's my advice. All right, here's a question that needs to be answered. What do Ryan Castle and your mom have in common?
Boy.
You're going to find out at 9:49 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
He's the drunk in charge. Now, the Ryan Castle question of the day.
What do Ryan Castle and your mom have in common?
I have pictures of you in the bathtub.
Yes. Oh, yeah, you do.
Mm-hmm. It's cold water, too, apparently.
Well, listen, what am I going to do, all right? The heater's off.
The texts are coming
just
in.
Just get out of the pool, Ryan.
Both make a killer fruitcake.
Oh, yeah.
They both sit down to pee.
Oh, really? They do? All right.
And Steve makes them both drool.
Oh. Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
He's a drooler.
Both dress Steve up in cowboy outfits.
Yeah.
That is very true.
Only the chaps, though.
Yeah.
Just chaps and the hat.
And the hat, yeah.
Maybe the boots.
And white socks.
You know, this is very descriptive. Got a new survey. Turns out 12% of adults say that when they get sick, what do? They still call their mom for comfort, advice, or both.
Oh.
Isn't that nice? Yeah. 61% say they take over-the-counter drugs. 44% go to a doctor. And 90% just ignore the illness and hope it goes away.
I never tell my mom if I'm sick.
Oh, really?
It'll be like 3 years later, she's like, how you doing? Are you still battling that cold? I'm like, it was 3 years ago. It was just a cold, Mom.
Yeah.
Like, she gets too worrisome.
I don't get sick.
Yeah.
Because I'm pickled.
Oh, is that it?
It's true.
And welcome
true.
Back from Vegas. Yeah. On an unrelated Thanks. Note.
Do yeah. I still smell bad?
Yeah, yeah, kind of. Ryan Castle, he may smell the way he smells, but he still has a morning 12-pack.
BJ and Migs play of the day.
What are you embarrassed about, man? That dumb fad that you took part in.
I just text, like, Steve, I was part of a sick-ass breakdancing crew back in middle school. I had a sweet flat top with lime cheese in the sides and a rat tail combo. Is this myself texting in?
Yeah.
We thought we were too legit to quit. And so cool, yet none of us had a girl and nobody cared when we'd set up our cardboard at the end of the hall and take turns doing backspins and whatnot. Ah, the good old days. This guy legitimately would be my best friend in
yeah.
middle school.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. Here's another question from a listener. I have a mountain of credit card bills and consumer debt. Can I still keep my house if I file bankruptcy?
Yes, you almost always can keep your home and your house, your car in a bankruptcy. Depending on what type of bankruptcy you file, would depend on whether or not, for example, you can keep your vehicles if you have payments on them still. You can almost always keep your home if you're current on the payments on your home, even in full bankruptcy. In Chapter 13, you can also keep those items. If you're behind on your house, you could catch your house payments up in a Chapter 13, take off a second mortgage in a Chapter 13. So keeping your primary assets like a home and car is almost always possible in bankruptcy.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. And thanks for listening.